Hi, I'm Ahmed Hassan. Welcome to Dreamscapes. On the last episode, we featured Hunter Industries' PGP Ultra and the I-20. On this episode of Dreamscapes, we'll feature their subsurface irrigation solution known as EcoMap. Now, during the install, we had some ridiculously wet weather. But what Dave and I are going to be talking about today is about irrigation solutions to help conserve water and still have a beautiful landscape.
Overhead.
Right, right. So we had to come up with something creative to get this irrigated.
Good. Hey, buddy.
Is this that whole EcoMat section?
This section here is all the EcoMat. It's that funky, hard to water with an overhead system area.
Are they talking too much again, Brian? You're just doing this.
Well, we're trying to teach Brian about the EcoMat system because, you know, where it applies in small, tight spaces that overhead irrigation just doesn't function well.
You know, I got a small demo of this stuff in my truck.
That would be good because I was going to dig this up and try to show it to him, but yeah. Yeah, it's buried. Right. So I got a little demo piece.
Okay. Give me a second.
Good. All right, so.
Rough plumbed in.
This is my demo. Let me show you what I got. Come on.
So, Brian, how many classes have you taken in horticulture?
A few.
Dave, do me a favor, hold this side.
You got it.
So remind me, you took soil science then, right?
Yeah.
So you remember in soil science where your teacher talked about water moves four different directions?
Mm-hmm.
What are the four different directions that water moves?
It moves downward through the soil.
Gravitational pull.
It'll move across.
It'll move across through capillary action.
It'll go through the plant itself.
It'll go up into the plant through, what do we call that again?
I don't know.
What do we call it growing up?
Transpiration.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Transpiration. Thank you, Dave. And then it moves upward through?
Evaporation.
Just evaporation, right? This is based off of capillary action. This fleece mat has been engineered, meaning it's the right thickness, it's the right size. It has the right size pores in there that the inline tubing, Hunter's PLD tubing that has the emitters built in every 12 inches,
mm-hmm.
is laced within this, wrapped. This water will actually, instead of just saturating out and going into maybe a circular area or depending on what the soil is, even in a sandy soil, you can finally get your water to move laterally with drip.
Okay. Well, despite your soil.
Yeah, despite your soil.
Independent of your soil, because some soils.
If you've got a clay-based soil, it's going to work that much better. Especially if you're trying to water turf, which is where we use it for here.
In an application like this, you're not spraying, you're overspraying. There's no way to efficiently apply water to this area overhead.
So here's the thing, let me set this down right here. We'll do the little squat down, because I'm curious to know how Tony actually laid this thing out. The idea behind this is that inline tubing has been used in irrigation for lawns and turf probably at least for the last 15 years. So the reason that this is even developed today is to try and combat really getting water to an entire area and being able to do that even in sandy soils. It gives us alternatives, it gives us options. Tony, how did you install this in this little section and where does it stop and start at? Because I mean, the turf looks all the same.
Yeah, they tell you they want it about 3 to 4 inches below the grade of your soil, of your final grade.
Okay.
And then we cover it with our native soil. We don't bring in topsoil, but we just cover it with soil, get our grade set, and then the turf's ready to be installed like normal turf.
So the other thing I really like about Hunter's EcoMap product is that you can get the inline drip emitter tubing only with the cloth cover for it skinny strips like this, right?
Okay.
So you don't have to take a whole, you know,
and cut pieces and stuff.
You know, square foot of material, cut it down, you know, 3 feet long, 1 foot wide, cut it down to meet a 4 inch thick area. It's been almost impossible to water that well, and this allows us to do that now.
Sweet. Well, I'm gonna keep my sample because it's not too dirty right now. I mean, think about how many different applications.
I know you can think for all day. You can
name applications. Well, for one, I can tell you we have in many jurisdictions, and now it's state law, you can't irrigate overhead along a curb or a walkway. So this is the only solution. So now you can put turf right up to the back edge of the curb and abide by the law.
Whether you have hard water, which is another filtration issue, or you have major water conservation regulations that you have to follow, EcoMat is gonna get hugely popular. Mark my word. Maybe I'll let you have that one. That's for you. Don't say I never gave you nothing. All right, guys, what else we got? Well, I'd really like to thank you all for sticking with us and watching this very informational, groundbreaking season of Dreamscapes. Whether you're doing your own small project or your very own dreamscape, you'll want to find yourself a good set of professionals, do your research, and always, always, always dream big. I'm Ahmed Hassan. I wish you well.